Controversial TV network SMNI files an appeal to block the month-long suspension of its operations. It claims the suspension order smacks of abuse of power and lack of due process. This report from RG Cruz.
Lawyers of Suarasug Media Corporation have asked the Court of Appeals to stop the National Telecommunications Commission from implementing its previous order suspending the operations of the network which operates Sunshine Media Network International or SMNI. SMNI legal officers Mark Tolentino and Rolex Suplico, who also host programs in the network, filed their petition for certiorari, prohibition and mandamus with prayer for the issuance of a temporary restraining order, preliminary injunction and injunction at the Court of Appeals office in Manila Thursday. Their petition claims that the NTC violated the Constitution in ordering the suspension based on a resolution of the House of Representatives, claiming it violated the Due Process Clause of the Constitution, the separation of powers between the executive and legislative, and the surrendering of the NTC's quasi-judicial powers to the House. The House earlier conducted hearings and found the network to have violated their franchise on three occasions: failing to get congressional consent for the change of ownership of its shares of stock, failing to disperse 30% of its ownership to the public, and failure of the responsibility to the public when it allegedly peddled fake news and threats. The last ground stems from complaints of lawmakers over claims that Speaker Martin Romualdez had 1.8 billion pesos in tribal funds, which were later found to be false, and the supposed threats against Representative Franz Castro by former President Rodrigo Duterte, both of which the network aired.
Bakit sila nagpayataw ng penalty ng suspension na wala pang due process? Hindi pa tayo pinagbigyan ng pagkakataon na sagutin yung mga allegation. In the very first place, wala pang allegation, wala pang complaint. Mahirapan kami sumagot sa mga allegation na wala naman dyan. So, para kami nanghuhula ngayon na ano yung sagot namin na wala pa namang complaint, wala pang specific na violation na sinasabi nila para masagot natin.
Para humingi ng justisya sa pang-aabuso ng ahensya ng gobyerno. Yan po ay National Telecommunications Commission. Apparently, yung tatlo doon, hindi na alam yung ginagawa nila. Kaya pumunta kami dito para ireklamo ang NTC sa pang-aabuso sa isang broadcast entity. Walang iba, SMNI.
Suplico called out the NTC for its action against the network when the supposed violations only involved two shows.
Dalawang programa lang sa SMNI ang nireklamo. Yung po ay gikan sa masa para sa masa at yung laban kasamang bayan. Bakit yung buong network ay pinarusahan? Diba dapat ang kasalanan ni Pedro kay Pedro lang? Hindi mo isabihin na buong network ay may kasalanan?
Tolentino meantime explained SMNI continues to operate in the digital space even while it is absent from the broadcast space because of the NTC suspension order. RG Cruz, EBS-CBN News.
And the clock is ticking for tens of thousands of transport workers who have yet to consolidate their jeepney franchises. With only 3 days left before the December 31st deadline, transport and commuters groups again turned to the High Court, urging it to promptly issue a temporary restraining order against the mandated franchise consolidation. They initially filed a petition for a TRO, but the Supreme Court has yet to reach a decision. Instead, transport authorities were directed to submit comments on the petition within 10 days.
Ang pinaka-purpose natin ay para makapaglabas ng TRO ang Korte Suprema at makita nila yung essential ng layunin ng pinay natin. Kapag hindi tayo binigyan ng muling makapag-renew ng ating mga prangkisa o ng ating mga PA, ang direct effect niyan ay magkakaroon ng malaking transport crisis ngayon na darating na January.
Kung isuspend nyo ang cancellation ng franchise sa January 1, hindi naman magugunaw ang mundo. Pero pag kinansilaan nyo ang mga prangkisa sa January 1, yun ang paggunaw ng mundo ng maraming driver, operator at pamilya nila at maraming mga pasahero.
Transport authorities are providing a bit of reprieve to jeepney drivers. Unconsolidated drivers are now allowed to ply select routes until January 31, 2024. Transport regulators say they will be allowed on public roads where less than 60% of jeepneys are consolidated. Despite that, government says the PUV consolidation deadline stays.
We invite all of our unconsolidated operators, meron pa pong panahon. Again, bukas ang LTFRB up to December 31, linggo, holiday, 5 p.m. para lang po mabigyan ng pagkakataon yung ating mga drivers at operators sa humabol doon po sa ating consolidation deadline, December 31.
Transport groups, meanwhile, warn phasing out traditional jeepneys will negatively impact the economy.
Malaking porsyento na halimbawa mawawala sa hanin ng ating public transport ay malaking epekto nga yan, hindi lamang sa hanin ng mga driver at operator, kundi sa ating mga mamay. Mismo sa ating ekonomiya, kapag nagkaroon po ng transport crisis sa ating bansa, ang direct effect niyan ay yung ating mismo yung ating ekonomiya. Yung sinasabi halimbawa ng mga taga LT public, taga DOTR, sinasabi nila papayagan namin yung mga tricycle, papayagan namin ng mga kung magbibigay kami ng mga special permit. Ito ay bahagi ng pagpapakita na talagang hindi konkreto at hindi malinaw yung programa sa balangkas ng modernization, kundi ang nagiging pagtugon lamang ay parang papachipat yung solusyon.
Over now to the maritime row between the Philippines and China. Beijing says it will not turn a blind eye to what it called repeated provocations and harassment by the Philippines. China's Defense Ministry insists actions taken by its Coast Guard were unnecessary, justified, and legitimate. It also called Manila's statements on their maritime encounters purely false hype. Earlier this month, China fired water cannons on Philippine vessels in two separate incidents, causing damage to resupply boats. The two sides have been blaming each other over escalating tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Top Philippine and U.S. diplomats discuss Manila's long-standing maritime row with Beijing. Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo spoke on the phone with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken. Blinken reaffirmed Washington's ironclad commitment to Manila under the Mutual Defense Treaty. Their phone conversation follows a warning from China for the U.S. to stop meddling in South China Sea issues. And let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Rhea Torres. Good morning, Rhea.
Good morning, Katrina. Good morning to all our televiewers. As of the moment, the northeast monsoon continues to affect northern and central Luzon, bringing cloudy skies and rains over Batanes and Babuyan Islands. Meanwhile, for the rest of the country, generally fair weather conditions are still expected, besides chances of isolated light rains over Metro Manila and large portions of Luzon, and isolated rain showers or thunderstorms over the areas of Bicol Region, Mimaropa, Visayas, and Mindanao. And since we are currently not monitoring any tropical cyclone or low-pressure area within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility, over the next few days until this coming new year, fair weather conditions may still persist over large portions of the country. However, frequent rain showers or thunderstorms may still be expected, especially around the eastern sections of Visayas and Mindanao, as well as Bicol region. And for the state of our coastal waters, we currently have no gale warning raised over any seaboards of the country. However, moderate to rough coastal waters may still be experienced over Luzon and the eastern section of Visayas. So seafarers, especially those with small sea crafts, are still advised to take caution when venturing out into the sea. And that is the latest here from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Thanks for that update, PAGASA forecaster Rhea Torres. Filipino households are ushering in the new year with the traditional medianoche. Let's check the prices of some New Year's Eve staples with Jervis Manahan.
The Department of Trade and Industry assured the public that medianoche items covered by its price guide will not increase prices until the end of the year. The agency's consumer protection group says manufacturers and retailers committed to keep their prices until December 31.
Kahit na Pasko na talagang nagmo-monitor tayo at saka yung mga reports na nagbebenta above the price guide, inaaksyonan, kinakausap po talaga natin agad-agad ang mga manufacturers. So sana po wala na po tayong maaasahan na pagtaas hanggang December 31.
DTI also said that they allow manufacturers to produce smaller products to cope with inflation while maintaining its price, a practice known as shrinkflation.
Kami, ang posisyon namin sa DTI, hinahayaan natin ang mga manufacturers na gawin yan kasi business decision nila na baguhin yung produkto, ibahin yung size, ibahin yung packaging, no? Pero ang babantayan natin, wag lang siyang mahulog doon sa sinasabi nating profiteering kasi illegal na po yan. So kapag ganyan, meron po yung penalties under the Price Act na ang DTI naman po ang nag-e-enforce.
Some people have started preparing for medianoche, the traditional meal shared by families on New Year's Eve. To bring good fortune, consumers would often buy 13 round fruits. The public should expect to pay more, As fruit stand vendors say, prices may go up by as much as 50 pesos per kilo before the new year.
Mahina po ngayon kasi syempre nagbabudget pa yung mga tao tsaka may mga pasok pa. Hindi pa naman, yung iba umuwi na sa probinsya. Medyo tataas ng konti sir, pero sa aming mga nagtitinda, depende na lang po sa mga tindera ang magpipresyo.
Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Here's a way to bid goodbye to the bad memories of 2023. The Good Riddance Day New York City is back for its 17th year. And those who wish to forget unpleasant memories of the past year are encouraged to write them on a piece of paper. A magician on site will then burn them into thin air.
The New Year's Eve celebration, part of the things that you do around a New Year's Eve celebration is you reflect on the year past, you celebrate the present moment, and you look to the year ahead. So this is our opportunity, this specific event, Good Riddance Day, is the opportunity to look at the year past. Maybe think of some of the negative things that happened, some of the things you'd like to get rid of.
So what do visitors want to leave in the past? Well, here's some of it.
I think just starting afresh and turning a new page for the both of us in 2024 is exactly why we're here today.
So what did you write?
So we said people pleasing, and we're both in grad school, so we're saying goodbye to grad school. What else?
And we said anxiety and self-doubt.
Yep, that's out the window.
I wish to end the end of the war, all wars, but you know, it's just horrible what's going on. Yeah. Political unrest, I wish for an end to that. Personally, I would like to stop saying should and just do things I want to do.